Are you rolling? I hope it's rolling because these are always my favorite parts. This is the part I always hope they keep and they never do. They always cut into the movie and this character in this movie. So this is my favorite part. So she's asking me to say, hi, I'm Michael Keaton. I thought you were going to say that. Let me hear you say it first.
You are Michael Keaton.
I am. Yeah. Why, are you questioning it now?
No,
I'm not. Hi, I'm Michael Keaton. I'm sorry to give you such a hard
time.
It's fine. Actually, no, my name's not Keaton. You know that, don't you?
Douglas
is my name.
Is it?
Uh-huh.
Michael Douglas.
Mm-hmm. And I just came back from Scotland because we were apparently crazy people up there. We hacked people's heads off. So careful in this interview. Because it's in me, isn't it?
Yeah. Well, this is about somebody's life, the founder.
Who was willing to hack people's heads off if he had to. Yes.
Have you ever wanted to do anything about your life then?
To hack people's heads off? There have been people I've thought, I'd like to hack their head right off. I admire him a great deal, actually, Roy Kroc, early on in his life, because why not? What did Roy Kroc do except work hard and have a vision and put in the hours and put in the time and put in the sweat? What's not to like, if you ask me? And then he takes a turn, and the movie takes a turn, which is what I think one of the things that makes the movie so good, is it doesn't back off what he did that he probably really didn't have to do. But as far as him taking control of something and blowing it up into something really big and being successful, got no issue.
Queen's Castle Sales.
Hi, Jim.
Ray, how's it going down there?
Good. Swell. A lot of interest.
We got an order. 6 mixers.
To anyone in particular?
McDonald's.
McDonald's?
Care for a little tour?
We wanted something different, and that's when my brother here comes up with one of his brilliant ideas.
Orders ready in 30 seconds, not 30 minutes.
Unique, original, there's nothing like this.
It's revolutionary.
It's exactly what it is. It's revolutionary.
What is that?
The Golden Arches.
It's a way to make the place stand out.
Huh.
There should be McDonald's everywhere. Franchise the damn thing.
What's the first step?
Just leave that to me.
The line actually that I pulled out, I really enjoyed in the film, where his wife says, when is enough going to be enough?
Yeah.
He says, probably never.
Right.
Have you ever been that driven and that focused on work and everything else can just fall by the wayside?
Most of the time.
Really?
Yeah. No, I'm not kidding. Of course, how else do you do it? I don't know any other way to do it.
That's fascinating as well. To like, that's a part of the story that's so, I think it draws you in.
Well, if someone asks me, what's the choice? What's the alternative? I don't know. And by the way, not like every movie is like, but basically I'm at work, aren't I? I mean, I gotta do the job. I gotta stay at least. I'm just talking minimally, you know. And some jobs are less demanding than others, I suppose. And sometimes I get lazy. I know that sometimes, and I don't like it. But basically, isn't that what you're supposed to do? I mean, that's the idea, isn't it?
Business is war. It's dog eat dog. I could be growing this thing at twice the pace.
I don't know what to say.
Say you'll renegotiate.
I can't.
Can't or won't?
For you as well, I'm wondering what kind of things you're being offered at the moment, because you, I know I've heard you speak in the past about your career's had ups and downs, as mm-hmm. a lot of people have. Definitely.
Not a lot of people, everybody.
Everybody, yeah. It's true.
Yeah.
Even Elvis.
Yeah. And not just in show business. A lot of people go through this. Roy Kroc went through it. Roy Kroc was not always... He wasn't doing very well at the time, but he wasn't starving at the time, but he was struggling a lot. But he had times where he was actually doing okay, and then he had times where he was really not doing well. But he just kept at it. You know, you see that in the movie. You know, you see him. That's what I admire about the guy. He won't quit. You know, he's tough.
So it was kind of similar with you. I quite like the duality, I suppose, of some of the past films you've made, and now you're doing Birdman, and then you're playing the Vulture as
well.
Yeah. I kind of like how
a lot of things with wings. I play a lot of things with wings.
It's kind of come full circle. Does it feel like that for you?
No, it's never a circle. I don't see it as a circle. Just things just kind of go like that. You know, just things go along. You know, like my recent electrocardiogram, which is rock friggin' solid. I have it framed.
Really?
Yeah. It's outstanding.
It was that good.
None of this. It's like, for my, I'm in the upper couple percent. I am.
Healthiest.
What you're gonna read tomorrow? Drops dead in the street. Too many Big Macs. Took them out.
Do you still eat at McDonald's?
I haven't for a long, long time. It's just not a way I live. I'm not saying, oh my God, no, I'd never do that. I'm not above anything. But no, just don't kind of eat like that.